Hello, Helena. It's Emily McVeigh, Executive Director of the United Way of the Lewis and Clark area. We're here for this week's United Way Partner Spotlight with Florence Crittenton. Welcome, Mitch and Heather.
Thanks.
Thank you
Welcome
so much,
back.
Emily.
Thanks.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Thank you. You too.
Tell us a little bit about Florence Crittenton.
Sure, yeah. So we are an organization that's been in Helena for 125 or maybe 26 years at this point, 125 years. Yeah, a long time. And of course, in that time, our programs and services have shifted and adapted and grown to meet the shifting and adapting and growing needs of the community. But at our heart, we've always been really focused on helping young parents and young families heal and grow and thrive and become more resilient people. And families. And we do that now with a variety of programs. We have residential therapeutic programs for young teen mothers and their children, as well as older moms who are pregnant and/or parenting that are also navigating a substance use disorder. We've also got a whole lot of wonderful community outreach, parents, coaching parents, home visitation type programs. And then we have a full early childhood education program that we've just moved into a new space in our new building. We'll talk about that a little later. But yeah, we've got a whole lot of great, really very family-centric programs.
Great. It's a quick overview of a lot of things.
Yeah, I tried to be concise. That's 125 years and 125 seconds, maybe.
Right. And you just hosted Paint the Town Pink,
We
which is
did.
like year
Indeed.
21 or so.
21st
20,
year, yeah,
21
you're
years. Yeah.
exactly right. Yeah.
How did that go?
It was a lot of fun. We had record attendance. We were sold out. We know it was record attendance because we squeezed a couple more tables into the space than we usually
Wow,
have.
520 this year.
I
Yeah,
saw the
so.
picture. It looked like a lot of people.
Yeah,
A lot of
yeah, but
people.
it wasn't too tight or anything. But yeah, record attendance. We had a really wonder. We had a, like some wonderful live and silent auctions, and I do really want to give a shout out to the. We had a really wonderful volunteer auction committee that did a lot of work to solicit and gather and package all of those wonderful items and experiences. And to their credit and to the community's credit, I would say 95% or more of those things were a full donation from friends and partners in the community and across the state. So really. Excuse me, I don't know why I'm stuttering. Really fantastic.
It's just that amazing.
It's just that amazing. I'm speechless.
I was
I'm
gonna say
literally
that.
speechless.
Yeah.
What else about that? You know, we're still kind of trying to dial in the final numbers, but last year, dollar-wise, was a record-setting year. It's looking very similar. And we're kind of excited about that because last year that put us in a position to give some of our staff a pretty substantial raise. Some of our hourly staff a raise, and we're looking to do something similar this year. Maybe that doesn't sound like a lot to people. I think it was maybe a $2 an hour raise last year. But you know, we, as I said, we're about families, we're about people and relationships, and a lot of our clients, especially in our residential programs, come to us because of trauma, and that trauma is almost always the result of relationships that they've had. And so our work is really focused on helping them heal and grow through new relationships. And so that really depends upon being able to hire and retain, you know, really highly qualified staff. So giving people a raise and is a huge
It's important.
benefit to us. And that's, you know, I mean, that's the community of Helena's support really directly translating into that sort of support. So.
And we had some really good corporate partners this year. Dick Anderson Construction was our presenting sponsor, and they're the main contractor for Project Sunshine, which we'll get to in a few minutes. But just really, it's always so heartwarming and rewarding to see the community come out in force like that, where it's, you know, that community commitment to not only our clients and our programs, but also to Project Sunshine is really important.
Yeah, and I don't want to get off track, but like just like with childcare, which we've talked about a lot on this show, the reimbursement rate for the services you provide does not cover the actual costs of the services you
It does
provide.
not.
So these fundraisers are hugely important because if it wasn't for those, you would not be paying the staff very well because the reimbursement rates are not that great. So these are very important to be able to pay the staff better than what the state is giving you to pay the staff.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
There's
so
a lot
true.
of conversations around that right now. But the generosity of the community, our corporate partners, our individuals, our donors, are what make us, allow us rather, to keep our doors open.
Yeah.
Because we would not be able to do that, because the numbers don't pencil out if we rely solely on Medicare and other reimbursement rates.
Mm-hmm. Right. You have to be out there grant writing and fundraising and
yes.
all of these things. So
yes.
very, very important.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So tell us about Project Sunshine. How's that going?
Oh gosh, there's so much excitement to share in that regard. As Mitch alluded to, we opened our new early education floor on January 2nd. Our kiddos went home for the holidays and came back to a brand new space. Huge props to our early ed team. Sarah Mitchell's the director of that, and they had to do some serious scrambling to get relicensed without ever closing the doors for scheduled care, which was really impressive. But now we are hip deep in the demolition of the residential floor. And it's delightfully noisy in our offices these days with some good loud music and some hammers and saws banging away. I was actually just upstairs on Sunday, and it's just fun to see it start to really transform and take shape. We're hoping to have our residential clients moved over to the Project Sunshine campus in June of 2024, which is right around the corner,
mm-hmm.
Which we're really excited about. But we've got a long way to go with the fundraising. So we're about 68% funded at this point. We've got some big asks out there, but community engagement, community involvement, again, circling back to that demonstrative, getting the community involved is really important. And we're just now kind of relaunching the public phase of our capital campaign.
All right. So overall, you said the girls that will move from the Harris Street house, all of that will move mm-hmm. over, and or will all of that move over in June, or do you have other things that will stay there and then
no
move
all
over?
All of our residential programs will move over, outpatient will move over.
Okay.
And right now we have sold the Harris facility to Youth Dynamics, and we're just leasing back until we can get our clients transitioned over. It's really important that they have stability, and so moving them before it's completely done is not the best choice. So
well, that noise probably wouldn't go well
noise,
with babies.
Noise, dust, chaos,
toddlers.
Right? Right, it's nap time. Oh, never mind. Yes, and then the proceeds from that sale will be endowed to fund the long-term maintenance fund of the Project Sunshine.
Okay.
It's a big campus. It's 3.7 acres, that big 30,000 square foot building, plus two individual family homes and one duplex, which allowed us to open the transitional living program, mm-hmm. Which is where those older moms that Mitch alluded to, when they're ready to transition into more independent living, but not necessarily fully independent living, they can move into those spaces. You know, they kind of practice living, if you will, as far as paying all the, paying rent and managing a budget and groceries and menus, all that stuff. And then when they're truly ready to transition into fully independent living, then we give their rent back to them for a little nest egg. And that program has been a huge blessing. You know, we call it the 100-foot cliff when you're going from, full-time residential support and housing to, their case managers, of course, stay with them and they continue their treatment plan, but they're kind of out in the world. And we've been able to really lessen the impact of that 100-foot cliff.
Yeah. So at some point, you'll have to do the middle part of the building where the offices are.
Yes. And we are. Mitch and I are on that floor, and we're very patiently waiting, knowing that we're tackling it from a prioritization schedule for sure.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And so once the residential clients are over and the transition is complete, then we'll start working on the main floor, and that's the middle floor of the property. And that'll have our development and administration, community-based services, and outpatient services will be on that floor. And it's offices, so it functions okay now. We'll just be making some improvements. So that renovation will be probably, I would imagine, the quickest.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
So when do you anticipate that being complete?
The goal is to have it done by the end of summer.
Nice.
So
you're pretty close.
Dare I say August, September? But it's construction, so it's squishy.
Yeah. It's been pretty on track so far.
It's been really on track. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's
FoodShare's been saying the same thing, so we'll all just keep on crossing our fingers that
yes.
all these things stay on track.
Right.
Yeah. So how do people learn more about Florence Crittenton, Project Sunshine, all the things you guys are doing?
Sure. Our main website that tells you all about all the things is florencecrittenton.org. And if you want to learn more specifically about Project Sunshine, it's projectsunshine.info. And now's a great time to learn more, and to, if you would like a tour, we'd be happy to do that, or schedule, you know, a conversation. Mm-hmm. Getting in front of folks is what we really need to be doing right now, both to raise awareness about the extent of our services, because a lot of folks think we just do pregnant and parenting teens, but also learning more about Project Sunshine and its incredible mm-hmm. impact on our ability to serve more families. Now's a great time to learn more, and I would be happy to visit with anyone about it.
Anything else before we sign off? Anything? Well, obviously you need monetary donations.
We do.
For the building project. Mm-hmm. Anything else people can do to support right now?
I think we're always interested in volunteers. Of course, we just, with Paint the Town Pink, that was an enormous volunteer mm-hmm. effort. Another group of people that deserve a lot of props, and we had more mm-hmm. than 100 volunteers involved in pulling that off, so that would be great. You know, we're always interested in volunteers, and that can look like a lot of things. Certainly the clients, as they're navigating life in the residential program, sometimes just need a break, or they need to attend appointments or other mm-hmm. things outside of the home, and so having someone to rock babies or play with kids is always welcome. Certainly they're trying to learn new skills like cooking and meal planning, and mm-hmm. so we've got some volunteers that come in and help with meal prep or just cooking for the clients, and so that's something else. That's another really useful way for people, an easy way to get involved in supporting what's happening.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I would just like to give a shout out to the community. You know, most of our individual contributions come from Helena, but the majority of our residential clients do not. And just kind of on the heels of Paint the Town Pink and some other things that have been going on, just the community of Helena has been so supportive. And just so grateful from the bottom of my heart personally, but also as an organization. The work that we do is not possible without the entire community pulling. So thank you.
Great. Thanks for joining us today, guys.
Thanks.
Thanks, Emily. It's always a treat.
Yeah. Thank you, Helena. We'll see you again next week.